Okay, so, oh darn. Right. These are the answers to worksheet 1 of unit 3. And so, I guess I'll just kind of talk through these for those of you that weren't here. I tried to make clear in class that you were to be describing the slope of these graphs. The slope, not the line, not where the line's going, not what the line is doing, but the slope. Now, this slope is constant. Yes, the line is going up. The line is going up, but the slope is constant. It's a constant steepness. The steepness is not changing. And furthermore, it's positive. So it's a constant slope and it's positive. That means the words that you are using to describe the slope are the words that describe the what? Velocity. The words that we use to describe the slope of a position time graph is the velocity. Remember, the slope of a position time graph is velocity. And that's a constant positive velocity, which means our motion map should have arrows that are what? Constant length and positive direction. Oh, look at that. Those words that we used to describe the slope are describing what our arrows look like. And our arrows represent the what? The velocity. The arrows on the motion map represent the velocity, which we just described as constant and positive. So I hope you're seeing how that works. Constant positive slope here means we have constant length arrows that are in the positive direction. Now, we knew where to start the motion map at the zero because the line here starts at the zero position. Then we have to add the A. What's the A in this case? Well, if it's a constant velocity, do we have any acceleration? No, because remember, acceleration is the change in velocity over time. Is velocity changing? No. Therefore, we don't have an acceleration. Because this graph here on a VT graph means constant velocity this way. It would be a horizontal line. How much slope does a horizontal line have? None. That's zero acceleration. Okay, so second graph. And again, I hope that you were putting a slopometer on this thing, okay, and seeing that the slopometer is going to do this on that curve. It's going to go and get steeper and steeper and steeper positively. Positively, it's increasing. The slope is getting steeper, it's increasing slope, and it's positive, which means our arrows here are positive and they're increasing in length. So remember, the words we are using to describe the velocity are describing the arrows we draw for velocity. I hope it's clicking. Then, the other day, we had these, let's see, let me switch. We had these statements right here. These statements. When we have speeding up, when there is speeding up going on, the acceleration and the velocity arrows have to be in the same direction. If they're slowing down, then the acceleration is in the opposite direction of the velocity arrows. So what do we have going on here? We have speeding up. So A has to be in the same direction as the velocity. Third graph. The line is going up, yet you see it says decreasing and positive because the slope is doing this. It's starting steep and positive, and it's going to this. The curve is starting steep like this. And again, if you take a pencil, hold it on the screen right now, and follow the curve with your pencil, you'll see the curve doing this. It's starting fast positive, and it's ending with none. So the arrows for our motion map have to be, I didn't ask for a motion map. Oh, dang. In class, I asked everyone to sketch a motion map for each of the graphs. And so, I guess you've already seen them now. I guess at this point, maybe it would be nice to pause the video and then try to sketch what the rest of the motion maps look like based on our discussion so far. Maybe. Maybe I should have hidden those. Maybe I should have hidden these down here and then revealed them one at a time and then had you try to sketch motion maps. So anyway, the arrows on our velocity are positive because it says positive, and they're getting smaller. They're decreasing in length, which means they have to start fast if they're going to get smaller. They have to start long if they're going to get smaller. But they're in the positive direction. Now, how do we know where to put our first dot on any of these? We have to look at the y-intercept here. Zero position start, zero on the motion map. Zero position start, zero on the motion map. Zero position start, zero on the motion map. In the positive direction, but decreasing in length. Because that says slowing down, our A has to be in the opposite direction of what it's going. If it's going this way and slowing down, then the A has to be this way. Okay. And decreasing, negative. If you look at this curve, it starts with a negative slope, steep negative. And if you follow the curve, you see it gets level. It gets zero, horizontal. It starts with a large negative slope, and it turns into no slope. So the slope is actually getting less steep. Again, it's very steep here. It's not steep at all here. Imagine yourself standing on this hill. That's steep. That's a steep part of the hill. This is not steep. So it's decreasing in steepness, and it's negative. With a large positive position at the start, which means you're going to start out here with a large positive position, with velocity arrows that are negative and are decreasing in length. And so what do we see? We see a large positive starting position with negative arrows that are decreasing in length, which means the A has to be in the opposite direction as the velocity arrows, because we have slowing down. And finally, the last graph starts horizontal and becomes negative, steep negative. So it starts with no slope at all, and it gets steeper. That's an increase. It's getting steeper. But it's a negative slope. Increasing and negative. So notice this line starts away from the origin on the positive side. Now see, here's the thing. Because people see the line going down, they think that's decreasing. Well, yeah, the position's getting, you're getting closer to zero position. But I'm not asking you to describe where it is or the position. I'm asking you to describe the slope. Steepness starts with none and gets steeper negatively. So that means my arrows have to get longer. They're increasing in length, but they also have to be negative direction. So they have to be in negative direction. Oh my gosh, which negative direction? And get longer, which we see is happening here. And because they're getting longer, that means the A has to be in the same direction as the velocity arrows. Same direction. I mean, same direction. So I don't know if that helps or not. I mean, in class, it was probably better because we looked at the graph individually and then we talked about the motion map and created the motion map as we went. Here, you didn't have to actually try to think through the motion map. You just saw it. And so I probably should have not shown you that had you tried to do that on your own. But again, I hope you're seeing that the words we use to describe the slope of the position time graph are describing velocity, which in turn describe the words on our, the arrows on our motion map for velocity. They are negative, but they're getting longer. They're negative and they're increasing in length. These are negative and they're decreasing in length. So again, the words tell you what should happen. Next, you had a data set here, okay? And you were supposed to plot the data set. So I have velocity on my y-axis in miles per hour. I have time on my x-axis in seconds. I plot the graph. I draw the best fit. I find the slope, which is done here, okay? So you should get something around 5 miles per hour for every second. You keep the units of measure. And again, some of you, like on the test, you're still not putting units of measure on your numbers. You have to put units of measure or the numbers mean nothing. They're just integers. They're just numbers. They have no meaning if you don't put a unit of measure on them. You have to describe or tell people what the number is, what it represents. And you do that by putting a unit of measure on it. Please, please. So we have 40 miles per hour of change. That's my rise. And we have 8 seconds over which it did that. That's, again, a 5 miles per hour for every 1 second change. Now, what does this slope represent? Well, remember, it's the slope of a velocity time graph. The slope of a velocity time graph is what we call acceleration. It is the change in velocity over the change in time. This is acceleration, okay? This is acceleration. It's telling us that the velocity changes by 5 miles per hour for every 1 second. This would be the explanation for what the slope means. Your velocity changes by 5 miles per hour every second. So after 1 second, how fast are you going? 5 miles per hour. After 2 seconds, how fast are you going? Another 5 miles per hour for a total of 10. After a third second, how fast are you going? Another 5 miles per hour, 15 miles per hour. And every second, you get 5 miles per hour faster and faster and faster. Now see, our old slopes of the position time graph were telling us how much our position changed every second. And it was a consistent value. Constant velocity meant that we had the same amount of position change every second that went by. Now we're finding out that our velocity is changing and that we have a constant amount of velocity change, 5 miles per hour, that it's changing every second that goes by. Consistent. But it's a consistent change in velocity. It's not a constant velocity. It's not a consistent change in position. A consistent change in position produces a constant velocity. A consistent change in velocity produces a constant acceleration. That's different. And we have page 2. Now, motion map. The motion map for the truck is this. Many people put constant length arrows on this motion map because you looked at the graph and you saw a constant slope like this and you said, oh, well, that has to be a constant. That has to be a constant length arrows because my slope's constant. But remember, folks, you're looking at a VT graph with a constant slope. A VT graph with a constant slope means constant acceleration. If you have an acceleration, you're not staying the same velocity, and your arrows for velocity can't stay the same size. This VT graph produces an XT graph that looks like this. These two graphs are communicating the same kind of motion, but they look completely different. Okay. The XT graph says, hey, it's going to start with a zero slope and it's going to get steeper as time goes on. That means it's going to produce a velocity that starts with none and gets bigger as time goes on. These two graphs are describing the exact same motion, but this one's telling us how the position changes as time goes on. And this one tells us how the velocity changes as time goes on. They look different, but they're communicating exactly the same motion. Then number 5, we describe in words the motion of the truck. Well, I would say that the truck travels in the positive direction. How do we know that? Because the velocities are all what? They're all positive velocities, which means it's got to be going in the positive direction because all of our velocities are positive. If the line on the VT graph was down here, then it would be negative velocities going the other way. So we have positive velocities because the line is above the T-axis. So the truck travels in the positive direction with a velocity that increases by 5 miles per hour for every 1 second. That's what the graph told us. The graph says by its slope that the velocity is increasing by 5 miles per hour every second. That's in my description now. I have those details that were given in the data. And so I can say, hey, the truck's traveling in the positive direction and it's getting faster by 5 miles per hour for every second. That's all we know. Do we know where the truck started? No. I just assumed the truck started at the zero position, but we don't know that because what can't we see on a velocity time graph? Position. We don't know what the position is. We only know how fast and what direction it was going. And lastly, you were supposed to write the equation of motion. The equation for the truck's motion represented by the line on the graph. That's the y equals mx plus b. Many people started their equation with the word position. It's not position anymore. You're not writing the equation for an xt graph. You're writing the equation for a velocity time graph. That means your y variable is now velocity. So velocity equals what? Your slope. Your 5 miles per hour for every second, which is your constant acceleration. That's what that value is, that's your acceleration. In the old equations, that was the constant velocity that showed up as our slope. In this equation, it's the constant acceleration that's showing up as our slope. The x variable is still time, like it was before. Time is the x variable. Again, v velocity is the y variable. And do we have a y-intercept here? No, because how much velocity did the truck have at the start? None. Therefore, we don't have a y-intercept. I put 0 miles per hour there, but do you have to? No. And so this tells us that the velocity of the truck is equal to how fast it's accelerating times how many seconds it's been doing that. That's it. There is another assignment that is posted on Classroom now. So you can get on there and do that one and then upload your picture of that assignment by either Monday or Tuesday or no. By Tuesday or Wednesday, depending on which class you're in. So hopefully this helped explain some things maybe that were confusing before. I don't know, but I will see you on the flip side. Take care. We'll see you later.